क्लास ट्वेल्थ सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स फोर्थ चैप्टर थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम एंड द थर्मोडायनेमिक प्रोसेस. सो लेट अस सी फर्स्ट व्हाट इज द थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम. ए थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम इज ए कलेक्शन और ए ग्रुप ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स that can form a unit which may have ability to exchange energy with its surroundings. A thermodynamic system is a collection or group of objects that can form a unit which may have ability to exchange energy with its surroundings. For example, let us see the system. Suppose water is filled in a vessel will represent the system. Then this represents the vessel which will act as the boundary between the environment, that is the surrounding space of this system, which is nothing but the surrounding or environment. So between this surrounding or environment and this system, there will be this boundary. Then if you consider the thermodynamic system, then it is classified into three different groups, and these are the open system, the closed system, and an isolated system. So these are the three different types of the thermodynamic system. So let us consider the first, that is open system. In this case, this water will represent the system, and therefore heat as well as matter both will get exchanged with the atmosphere. And therefore an open system is a system that freely allows exchange of energy and matter with its environment. So from this figure it is clear that these two arrows are representing heat and matter. So if it is open system, then both heat as well as matter will be exchanged by that system with the environment, and so that it is called as open system. So as an example, we can consider boiling water. So water boiling in a kettle is an open system. Heat will escape into the air, and this is the exchange of energy with the surroundings or the environment. At the same time, steam is also escaping into the air, and this will be the exchange of matter with the surrounding. That means from this diagram, the heat will be given to the atmosphere or the surrounding or the environment, and therefore there will be exchange of heat. Similarly, the steam of this boiling water will also escape into the air in the environment, and therefore there will be exchange of matter. So in case of open system, there will be exchange of both heat as well as matter. In the second diagram, if you consider the closed system, then in this case this water will represent now the system, and now one lid will be kept here on this kettle so that it will be acting as the closed system. Now in this case only there will be exchange of heat energy from the system to its environment or the surrounding, and therefore a closed system does not allow exchange of matter but allows energy, that is heat, to be transferred. So such type of system is called as closed system. So in case of a closed system, there will be only exchange of heat energy and no exchange of matter. So if you consider again the same example, that is water boiling in a boiler will act as a closed system. It allows heat, that is energy, to be transferred from the source of heat like burner to the water, that is system inside. Similarly, heat is also transferred to the surroundings. Steam, that is matter, is not allowed to escape as it is closed with the lid as long as the hollow is kept closed. That is, as when that lid is kept closed, there will be no exchange of matter between the system and its environment or the surrounding. So in case of closed system, there will be exchange of only heat energy and not the matter. Now let us consider the third one, that is isolated system. So this system will be sealed, or it will be kept isolated from its surroundings, and therefore there will be no exchange of heat energy as well as the matter. And therefore an isolated system is completely sealed system, that is, it is isolated from its surroundings. And therefore in this case, matter as well as heat cannot be exchanged with its environment. There will be no exchange of matter as well as heat with the surrounding or the environment. For example, a thermos flask is the example of an isolated system, because when it is closed, at that time it will be isolated from its environment or the surroundings. So these are the three different types of the thermodynamic system, that is open system, closed system and isolated system. If the system is open, there will be exchange of both heat energy as well as matter between the system and its environment. If it is closed system, there will be only exchange of heat and not the matter between the system and the environment. On the other hand, if it is an isolated system, then there will be no exchange of both heat energy as well as matter between the system and the surrounding. Now let us see what is the thermodynamic process. A thermodynamic process is the process in which the thermodynamic state of a system is changed. A thermodynamic process is the process in which the thermodynamic state of a system is changed. So now we will consider one example. So water contained in a vessel with a lid on it is an open system. When the pot, that is vessel, is heated externally, water starts boiling after some time. And when it is boiling, the steam is produced, which exerts the pressure on the walls of the vessel. In this case, the state of the water in the vessel is changed. This is because the temperature T, the volume V, and the pressure P of the water inside the vessel change when it starts boiling. So this will be regarding thermodynamic process. Now let us see the next point, that is heat, that is transfer of heat. How there will be transfer of heat, exchange of heat between the system and its surroundings. A heat is related with the internal energy of the system. Now consider a glass filled with water and kept on a table. The glass along with water in it forms a system. So glass and water both will form a system. Let TS be the temperature of the system. And now the table and the other relevant parts of the room, that is rest part of the room along with that table, will be then its surroundings or environment. Let TE be the temperature of the surroundings or environment. Now when TS and TE are not the same, then TS will change until both the temperatures are equal and a thermal equilibrium state will be reached. That is, TS will become equal to TE. Thus, a change in temperature takes place due to the transfer of internal energy between the system and the environment. So that will be the transfer of heat or exchange of heat between the system and its surrounding. Now we will discuss three different cases depending upon the temperatures of the system and the environment. So consider the energy transfer between a system and its environment. So here in this diagram, this will be represent the system. Outside the system, there will be environment. System is having its temperature TS and environment is having its temperature TE. Now, if you consider this system and if the temperature of this system is less than the temperature of the environment, that is TS is less than TE, at that time, the heat energy Q, the quantity of heat energy Q will enter into this system from the surrounding. That is, there will be gain of energy by the system from the environment, and therefore this Q will be greater than zero. That is, it will be considered as positive. So when temperature of the system is less than temperature of the environment, there will be gain of energy by the system. In the second case, again, if you consider this system and the environment, and if the temperature of the system is greater than now temperature of the environment, if the temperature of the system is greater than temperature of the environment, at that time, this system will lose some part of energy Q. So here, heat energy will be given out by the system to its environment, and therefore Q is less than zero, that is, it is taken as negative. So when temperature of the system is greater than temperature of the environment, at that time there will be loss of heat energy by the system. Now let us consider the third case in which the temperature of the system is equal to temperature of the surrounding. Both temperatures are same. At that time there will be no transfer of heat energy from the system to the environment or from the environment to the system, and therefore Q will be equal to zero. There will be no gain or loss of energy by the system.